Kalyan, if you are getting ready to, if you're ready, we can go ahead and get started. Are you good?
Yes, we can get started. Yeah.
All right. Sounds good. So who all is going to be speaking to you today? I am Bria. I am on the product marketing team here at SmartBear for our test products, including TestComplete, QAComplete, CrossBrowserTesting, as well as AlertSite. And I'm super fortunate and super grateful to be joined by Kalyan McCullough. So I'll let you introduce yourself real quickly.
Hi, good afternoon, guys. I'm Kalyan McCullough, and I'm my current role is a principal. I work as a principal test architect at Pega Systems. It's a headquarters. Our headquarters are located in Cambridge, Massachusetts, and I've been working in automation for a really long time. Basically, my background is I'm a math background. I have a math background, but also got into security and been in automation and DevOps and security for a really long time. For the past, I'll say around 10 years or so. For the past decade, I've been in this particular field, so pretty familiar with all the all the developments in this particular field. And I'm very honored to join this particular webinar. Thanks again.
We are so super grateful to have you here. So as you can tell, you know, we have people here from the SmartBear side, but also people here from, you know, the end users and who are using our tools every day with Selenium. And so we challenge you to ask us any questions you might have and how we can make your life easier. So with that, let's kick it off. So, you know, what is Selenium? Selenium is an open source framework and ecosystem. It's used for simulating and testing user interactions on the web. So really, it's an automated UI functional testing tool for web testing. It's an open source free tool, and it's definitely one that is very popular and being used throughout. And so I know, Kalyan, when we were discussing this, you know, we talked about the three different parts of Selenium. Do you want to dive a little bit deeper into that?
Yes. So as Bria mentioned, right, it's an open source tool, as well as if your current version of Selenium, it's been supported by Google. So if you look at the developments from 2007 till 2018, so there are a lot of versions of Selenium, it has come through. So initially we used to have RC, Selenium RC, IDE, and we had Grid, right? So and also in 2011 in August, we got WebDriver 2.0 was introduced. And if you see the architecture of WebDriver 2.0, it's completely different from RC, right? And the current version of Selenium WebDriver 3.0, and if you, best way to for you to get to learn about Selenium more is just go to seleniumhq.com and go through the documentations, also read the change log, and it will show you what have the improvements that they have done over time. So if you look at the current build itself, the 3.1, I think 3.11, it's like pretty stable. There is a lot of support from Google, and also the developer in terms of the support too, it's a lot of support is still available. But best way to get started is going through the documentation, going into the website, and learning more about it. Right now, there are in terms of Selenium, there are four components. One is WebDriver. You have IDE. You have Grid, and you have the remote web driver. So these are the different four components of it.
Absolutely. And so, you know, with all of the offerings that it has, there are definitely many benefits to Selenium. You know, first off, everyone loves the word free, right? And it's a free and an open source tool. So you can download it for free. It's community-based. You can make it exactly what you need. It also has multi-platform support, excuse me. And Selenium, it can operate and support across multiple operating systems and browsers. So if you're using a Mac, if you're using a Windows machine, Linux, whatever, it's really great that it can support that. It also has multi-language and framework support. So some of the terms you might have heard thrown around there, Mocha, Protractor, Cucumber, TestNG, are some of the various frameworks that are Selenium testing frameworks that you can use as a guideline when building your test. But also, it has a lot of languages that it supports, such as Java, Perl, Python, C#, Ruby, Groovy, and JavaScript. And with all of this support, it means, you know, you have a lot more options when you're looking to code for your tests, and you can code in something that you are comfortable with. And finally, reusability and integrations. Selenium has a lot of opportunity to actually integrate with other tools. And if you are looking to, you know, do automation with other tools, or if you're looking for a test management platform tool, you can integrate your Selenium test and have all of that in one area. So So it's really nice to integrate with other tools and guarantee maximum test coverage. Are there any other benefits you'd add, Callum?
I mean, this is, you're covering most of it right now. That's good.
Awesome. Sounds great. And I just want to briefly cover this because there are a lot of frameworks out there, and this is just the start of them, and not even that. There are so many out there, but these are some of the names that you might hear about Selenium testing frameworks: WebDriver.io, InternJS, TestNG, and then there are other more common ones like Mocha, a framework used for unit testing. There's Protractor, a framework used for end-to-end testing, and Nightwatch, another framework used for end-to-end testing. So all of these are Selenium frameworks, meaning that if you are looking for a tool that integrates with Selenium and you are looking and you hear any of these frameworks that are integrated with, it means that you can also use Selenium to build one of these frameworks and integrate with a tool if you are looking at evaluating a various tool. I encourage you, if you are looking at building a framework with Selenium, to find the one that fits your best need. If whether that's for end-to-end testing, unit testing, BDD development, et cetera. And so with that, you know, Selenium can't have everything in the world. And so there are some drawbacks, and that's why we wanted to talk to you about how can you get more out of your Selenium tests. So some of the drawbacks include there is no object repository. So if you're quickly looking to build stable tests, there isn't a set repository that you can say, hey, here is this button that I want to repeat and click on, and it can quickly identify that. Additionally, there's no support. I don't know about you all, but sometimes I would get stuck coding and there was nothing that was more frustrating when I didn't have someone to answer my questions when I was stuck. And this can be really frustrating, and you can waste a lot of time troubleshooting or having to start from scratch. There is a community available to answer your questions, but there is no support ticket that you can enter. There's no customer service, customer success representative who can help you. And also it can take a long time to ramp up on. Additionally, it can be difficult to scale. So unless you're looking at Selenium Grid, it is really difficult to actually get the right amount of test coverage you want through cross-browser testing or parallel testing. You can build that Selenium Grid, but that can be extremely difficult and time-consuming to actually maintain. And finally, there's no record and replay. So Selenium is great if you're extremely comfortable coding in one of the languages we discussed. However, if you have a team that has a mixed skill set, then there's no record and replay option to get people started with using Selenium or with using and getting started moving from manual to automation. Are there any other drawbacks you'd add, Callion?
So these are, I think you covered the drawbacks part of it, but the record and replay part of it is like, you know, there are, as I mentioned, right, there are four components. The one of the other components where you can do the record and replay is the IDE. People tend to think that record and replay is, you can use that for, you can use it, but it's not scalable. So if, for example, if you have in your project, if you have to automate around thousands of test cases, right? So you cannot automate, you cannot keep on recording those scripts. The generated scripts, is you get a lot of flakiness with the IDE. So you can use IDE, the record and replay component of the Selenium, but it's not for really complex test cases that you are going to automate. So you need to have you need to write dynamic scripting. So programming has to be part of it. If you want to really take the best advantage of Selenium, you have to be good at least one programming language. So there are several, as she mentioned, right? Like there are, Selenium supports several languages, Java, Python, Ruby. So just look at, pick one programming language that suits your firm, and also make sure that you pick up develop a framework in such a way that, right, you are trying to maintain the testing pyramids sane. You always try to keep the testing pyramid sane, and also build in a, look at the different design patterns. So yeah, there is a lot of learning that goes in when you build into framework. So I can get more details into more details of it later on. But for now, the record and replay part of it is, there is a big limitation to it. Don't, my suggestion is don't stick with the IDE for your automation needs. Don't stick with it.
Yeah.
So it's only for doing a very minimal testing you can do with the IDE.
I think you highlighted it exactly. Yes, there is the record and replay functionality, but is it going to actually help you create a stable and robust test? Most likely not. It's going to involve a really flaky test and things that we often try to avoid when we're actually creating test frameworks for testing.
Yes.
So why do you need more than just Selenium? And, you know, this gets back to something we've heard so often is the promise of the new software development lifecycle. We always want to go faster. And how do we continue to go faster without compromising quality? We all have pressure. I'm sure everyone here has heard from their bosses that we need to release faster. We're going to start adopting an agile methodology, a DevOps methodology. We're going to start shifting left and doing all of these things to go faster. How do we make sure we're doing that without compromising quality? And this is where scalability really comes into discussion with Selenium, is that using Selenium as a solution can be really difficult to scale. And you can do it with, you know, methodologies such as Agile and DevOps, but you can also get more if you partner Selenium with an additional tool. Additionally, we are seeing that in every aspect of our testing, the amount of web testing that is being done is growing exponentially, as well as the number of features that are being done. The popularity of various features being used is also increased. So as our products continue to mature, we're going to have an increased number of test cases to run in our regression before deployments. So this adds exponential amounts of testing and test execution time. And so really we're focused here on how are we going to save that time without compromising the quality and the product that we are delivering to our end customer. I think we can all agree that if there is a bug, our end customer will find it. So how do we make sure we can avoid that at the end of the day? And that's where we are trying to help you here at SmartBear. So Selenium and SmartBear. So where does SmartBear come in? All right, we've talked about Selenium. And when we look at the SDLC phases, we see that Selenium falls under the test phase. It makes sense. But here at SmartBear, we have two other tools that can also help you with your UI functional testing, automated functional testing, that is cross-browser testing, as well as TestComplete. So we'll go into how these two tools can integrate with Selenium and what you can get out of them, and also walk through demos of both of these products. Next up is AlertSite. This is our monitoring tool. You can actually take a Selenium script that you're using to test with and actually use it in a monitor live time, so you get the complete coverage over time of what you need to monitor and make sure that your application is performing to your requirements. And finally, we have QAComplete, which is our test management platform. And you can also import your Selenium scripts and tests into QAComplete. So you can have a single unified view of all of your testing efforts, whether that's manual testing, Selenium tests, or other automated proprietary tools. So with this, we want to dive deeper into each one of these, and we're going to start with TestComplete. So you might already be using a Selenium unit test framework that you like, and that's great. And we want to tell you how you can get a little bit more out of it. So TestComplete supports Selenium WebDriver tests created with frameworks you're using. This includes JUnit, TestNG, NUnit, PyUnit, Ruby, and PHP Unit. And what are some of the benefits that you can get out of it? One is distributed testing. TestComplete was built with the idea of continuous testing frameworks to test nonstop with a runtime engine and distributed testing, basically maximizing the amount of tests you can run at once. Also, you get manageable maintenance. So it helps you build robust and scalable GUI tests to minimize maintenance needs and save time. Also, a really nice feature is TestComplete includes a record and replay functionality. So if you have a team that has the needs to use a record and replay tool, you can use your Selenium scripts as well as your record and replay tools all in one IDE. So you don't have to mess around with multiple areas of maintenance, and it's a lot more scalable, as well as test reporting and analysis. You can get real-time information on the progress and status of all your automated testing efforts in a single interface. So finally, we want to highlight the last point, which is fast and expert support. No matter what, for all of our SmartBear solutions, we're always going to be here to support you with free academy classes and ramp-up materials, dedicated customer success representatives, as well as support tickets that are always ready and available to you. So the next solution we want to discuss is Selenium and cross-browser testing. So what this means is you can use your Selenium or Appium scripts that get created and executed as normal with only a few changes in our cross-browser testing cloud. You can maximize the amount of test coverage running, say, on Internet Explorer, on a Windows machine, or testing on Safari on your mobile device. So this can be really nice and helpful for testing and guaranteeing maximum test coverage. Anything you want to add to this slide, Kalyan?
We can cover in our demo, like exactly like how we use this particular feature for launching the CBT.
Awesome. Sounds good.
And also there are certain questions that I saw someone was asking how to compare two different URLs. I hope he's asking about visual regression there. I think in the demo we'll cover that part as well.
Yep. I see exactly what you mean. We are trying to answer the questions as they come in, but they're flying in, which is awesome. So keep them coming and we'll make sure that we tailor the rest of the presentation and demo to all of your questions. So what are some of the benefits of using Selenium in cross-browser testing? So first off is you can speed up build times. You're going to decrease the amount of time you spend on builds and invest that time in other projects through parallel testing. You can improve test coverage. You know, we talked a little bit about this and getting maximum test coverage on different devices or operating systems that you need to test against that your end user might be using. Reducing the total cost of ownership. Putting resources that you would spend maintaining Selenium tests towards other projects as well as maintenance is way more manageable. You're enhancing your remote teams, allowing access from all different locations by moving your tests from local to the cloud. So there are some other ones, easy debugging, and you know we'll show you screenshots and how you can easily share any type of bugs you find with other team members, as well as bug documenting with integrations like Slack and HipChat, Jira tickets, etc. You can do that all from right within cross-browser testing. And finally, you know, there's that seamless transition to mobile web tests. So if you're looking at running a test on Safari, on Google Chrome, all on your mobile device, you can write your Selenium scripts for one browser and run them against desktop and other mobile browsers. So next up is our monitoring tool. And don't worry, we are getting to the demos here shortly. And so it is really important to have monitoring. You know, testing is a really great way to capture the state of an application, verify different stress thresholds, as well as identify defects and code issues. Monitoring is a great way to assess performance over time, understand the delivery and performance of key user journeys, and identify performance and availability deviations. So it's really nice, you know, it's testing and monitoring go hand in hand, and it provides you that insight that your application is healthy, that the performance is being maintained, and it's living up to what it should be doing for your application. So last but not least, we have QAComplete, our test management platform. And QAComplete is really nice because it just brings everything together. It brings in all of your manual tests, your automated tests, your Selenium tests, your TestComplete, SOAP UI tests. It also brings in from your planning of your requirements through bugs you have found, and as well as your tests that you are using for your monitoring. And so it brings it into a single unified platform. And you can see exactly what's being covered and what are some gaps that you need to fill. It helps you detect things earlier. It speeds up everything. And it's just really nice as a project manager to have that unified view into all of the testing activities that are going on.